Day 25. The large amount of magic that has been done over the past few weeks has taken its toll on me. The druid Nemsen has suggested that I write my stories down, so I can calm my mind and perhaps be able to improve my knowledge. More and more encounters with the so-called Eldritch Realm has been occurring, but perhaps in the future I will be able to profit from them. Creating the void-aspected Silverwood Scepter has certainly changed the way I feel about the mythical energies surrounding me. Is it all for the greater good? I'm not too sure about yet, but it's
Everything changes.
Hey guys, and welcome to another video. This video will be episode 25 of Utopia Cubed 2.0 Age of Adventure. Ah yeah, we're back. So, pretty cool. So, what I want to do this episode? Well, like I said last episode, I want to start off with finishing my awesome wand. But before I do that, I want to make a little of change to the way I am currently handling Aura Notes. As you know from, I believe, two episodes ago, or three, I set up this energized node, which has been powering pretty much my entire contraption right here and has been running very solidly. But I think that I would profit a lot more from turning this node into an energized node instead of using this as a normal node to charge stuff from, because I am planning to use highly powerful nodes in these spots anyway, so that's what I am planning on doing. So, let's see. Where are those things located again? Yes, here we are. First of all, I will need another node stabilizer, which is not crazily bad to do. Let's quickly take this out before I craft the wand, because once I actually got this going, it will even make wand making a lot easier. Trust me on that. So, let's see. And then, what did go in the top again? Piece of gold, okay, I should be able to easily manage that. One of these, fancy. And then I need to put these four surrounding it, I believe. And then iron comparator, iron comparator, or a node, other way around, sorry. One node transducer, yeah. I can leave this in here for now. So, as you can see, I also made a little window in this so I can see through this, and I put myself some V-relay surrounding this. But I will need to make myself one more V-relay, or two for that matter, and make myself two Greatwood rods, so I can make myself something also pretty awesome, which is the V-charge relay. This thing will allow me to charge my wand straight from this arcane worktable. But before I do that, like I said, I will need to turn this one node into a very powerful one. So, first of all, let's quickly turn this thing on, because I want it to be as stable as can be. Then, I need to put this thing on. Let's quickly fly up here. There we go. And a block of redstone to power this entire contraption. So, as you can see, it's already very quickly draining all of the aspects, but that's a good thing. Well, I guess it's a good thing. It's at least what's supposed to happen, so pretty cool. Also, if I recall correctly, it will turn all these compound aspects, pretty much like Perfodio and Slime and Talum and all of that stuff, into a normal version, pretty much their base aspects, or primal aspects, I should call them, which is actually pretty cool, at least as far as I know. I did not test this with a highly powerful node, so this is also a little bit new to me. But I'm sure it will work out. So this does take a moment or two to do. But I think it will be pretty useful, because instead of having a finite amount, I will just be having an infinite amount, but a lot slower. So yeah, as you can see, I currently got myself 6 Ignis, 5 Perdito, 7 Ordo, 4 Aqua, 4, 5 Air, and 8 Terra, which is awesome. So, let's see, I don't want this to be connected like this. Can I pick it up? Yeah. Where can I put this so it doesn't straight up connect? Maybe right there? No, can I not place it on Silverwood? Apparently. I cannot. Can I place it right there, or... Okay, I guess for now this will do, and then later on I will fix that. But let's see. Put this V-relay on this thing, and... Oh, it's doing things! Oh god, that is fast. What? How is that possible? From what I saw from videos, it was like super slow. And this is... this is crazily fast. Oh, that's awesome. Well, there we go. That's my new solution to doing this kind of stuff. Wow. Oh yeah, right, of course. It says the same amount per tick. So I guess that's normal because this thing should emit like 20 times the amount that you can see in that order storage thing. But let's see. Since this thing is currently recharging on its own, very fast, I should be able to make my scepter in no time. And oh, this will make it so much easier for me to do future crafting. So let's just wait a couple of seconds. 1, 2, 3. I said 1, 2, 3. Alright guys, tell me embossed Silverwood stuff. This thing is awesome. Let's see, can I... Oh wait, yeah, of course I cannot recharge it normally. And yeah, so what I will need to do is probably make 2 more pedestals pretty much and break these things off so I can actually charge this baby. But something I can do now, which is pretty cool, is get my wand caps out and turn flight off. And oh wait, yeah, oops, I forgot that I messed that up. I changed my key configs, but I did not think about the foci. Am I just turning around like that? Might be easier. There we go. So I can now just straight up use caps on this wand. Awesome. And this thing can store 250 V, which is like, well, quite a huge amount, actually. Do I got one aura node nearby? Like, really nearby? I believe I do. So I can just quickly show you guys how fast this thing actually, or how efficient this thing is. Because that's the first thing that I would like to see. Let's quickly turn my wand cap off, though. Okay, it drains at normal speed, nothing too extreme apparently. But this thing has an 80% efficiency. That's not too bad, that's the same as my normal wand. But pretty much the upgrade for this thing is that it can store a lot more V, which is awesome. And close to exactly what I wanted to do. Also something I believe, I'm not sure if this is like completely true or not, that's what I thought I understood from videos. Do I still got... yes, I do. I got myself this recharge or V-stone. And I'm also thinking of making an upgrade for this, but that probably won't be for a future episode, though. If I stand near a V-relay, I should be able to recharge this, if that's true. Or maybe I should wear it? Yes, awesome. And while holding this thing, I'm currently recharging my wand from standing simply next to this thing. Oh, that's just awesome, guys. And also, like this. This wand is now completely charged, so I can straight up do a lot more infusion. This is awesome. It is, like, extremely slow, though. And, wait, what is it doing? Huh? Like, 0.56, 0.8, 1.1, 0.2. Nope, it actually seems to be working now. Oh, this will take a long time when doing it like this. But now I am able to recharge it pretty much however much I want. And also, I believe this thing can be used on aura nodes too, so that's pretty awesome. So yeah, I'll be right back, guys. Okay, guys. So I just thought, like, why would I wait for the next episode to do this? Why not just make it now? So yeah, pretty much what I am planning on doing now. So first of all, I will need to turn these into the mixed cluster shards, which I always like to make a few extra of just in case, because, you know, I might need them. Then I need to make this stuff, which is also quite expensive. And oh wow, I only got 2 air shards. Do I please say I got an extra primal charm? Otherwise I might need to do a little bit of mining first. Or do I got some in here? Yes, awesome, I got some in here. Oh, that's awesome. So let's see, I'll make 4 primal charms, because, well, I'll probably use them for something someday, and otherwise I'll just sell them to someone on the server. because it's really cool, because we are trying to create ourselves sort of out of an economy on the server. Like, I know some people, I believe Profound Games is planning to sell Blood Magic stuff, and, well, I am selling, or planning on selling, that is, Thumbcraft stuff, and we got, like, a bank for stuff, and also, like, something, I believe someone was trying to make an obsidian farm of some sort. I'm not really sure yet, but we got a lot of cool stuff planned, so that's pretty cool. Let's see, air, fire, water, so that's air, fire, water, and then earth, order, entropy, earth, order, and entropy. That's so awesome, and of course it auto recharges, which I love, as you can see and understand probably, because it's just so cool. Let's see. Then what I need to make is a mundane amulet. I'm not sure. Do I maybe have one already? I might have, but I'm not too sure yet. I don't have it in here. Nope. Maybe random loot, because I'm fairly certain I once picked up something like that. Maybe. Nope. How does one craft a mundane amulet? Oh, that's really cheap. I was expecting it to be like a lot more expensive, like requiring a lot more other work and a lot of components. And nope, apparently not. Straight up, forward, easy stuff. String. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And this baby. Pretty much, if I wear that thing, it will allow me to carry, combined with all the other things that I got around me. And am I currently also recharging stuff? Like, oh no, I'm not sure how big the radius is. Maybe also on the ground? No, apparently not. But let's see. This goes right there. Then Primal Charm. Primal Charm. Not Primal Charm. That's a backup in case one gets destroyed or popped off, because that's always a possibility. And then right there and right there. Okay, that's awesome. Okay, what aspects do I need? 24 Aurum. I do not have that yet, but I can make that. 64 Potentia, which I absolutely got. 64 Percantio, which I also absolutely have. I'm also thinking of maybe replacing this with gloss, just so I can see it a little bit better. But yeah, stuff for the future, like always. And I got more than enough vacuous. So let me quickly make a little bit of aurum, and I will be right back. Alright guys, that's easy enough, just currently burning some ethereal essence. So yeah, I just got this from flying around pretty far from my base and breaking notes that no one is using anyway. Which also adds to a little bit of aspect to the whole idea of the Age of Adventure. Pretty much, I have to adventure to not pretty much break all aura nodes that are around my base. So yeah, that's, I guess, quite of a cool idea. Next thing I want to see is, can I activate this stuff with my Tommy embossed stuff? Or do I need to use the other things for that? I'll see that in a sec. So, Golem, how are you doing? 24. That's 21. Still a little bit more. I can see the stuff being in here. Golem, take the aurum out so I can start. Ah, yes. This golem listened properly to me this time. So, guys, it's time for another major infusion. Final check. Yep, seems to be all right. Let's do this. I can also see all the things that are happening, so that should be good, in case something gets popped off or something. So I got clear vision of all the stuff that's happening around me. Potentia being drawn in. Yes. This is really a lot of potentia. Like, or also not just potentia, but also Precantio. It's like a full stack of that stuff, which is honestly quite expensive if you think about it. You have to burn down a lot of cool compound stuff for that. But sure, this thing can store 250V. I mean, that's insane. I mean, yeah, I don't even know if I've got any words for that. I mean, I can make my gear so overpowered. Well, overpowered. Well, maybe a little bit overpowered. Like, it is highly expensive and it takes a lot of time to do. Like, I'm already working like 3 episodes to make all this stuff. But still, it's awesome. I really hope you guys are excited as me about TomCraft, because especially this season, TomCraft is really my mod on the server, and I'm just enjoying it extremely well. And yeah, just cool stuff. And I'm surprised that nothing went wrong yet. I already got like over 2 stacks of aspects into this system, and nothing has gone wrong. Uh-oh. Why did I have to say that? Because every time, of course, when I say that, it suddenly starts attacking me. Stupid game. That's one Primal Charm. That's one cluster. Second cluster. Primal Charm. Third cluster. And final cluster. Alright. Guys, do you know what this means? I mean, I'm not even sure if I can understand what this means. Like, just look at this. I'm standing right here for now. Just should be able to charge me up. And, oh, graphical glitch. Oh, wait, it's probably because of the multi-parts. Ah, probably have to change something around that too. But I'm just standing here and I'm recharging this thing that can store 250V. Combined with the current staff that I got in my hand that can store 250V. I got myself a Void Aspected Silverwood Scepter that can store 150V and charges at an immense rate. This is crazy! TomCraft, I love you! Like, it's awesome. But of course, as you can see, this is very slow. So that's the main reason why I'm currently working on creating the very powerful notes that I got right here. So, yeah, I'll be right back. Alright guys, I got myself quite a cool idea of something that I would like to make. I mean, this Stomium armor is quite cool and I really like carrying it around all the time. But sadly, it's not very powerful. So, I think it's time to start working on some powerful armor. Of course, I'm referring to Stomium Fortress armor. Since I am not yet powerful enough to make Void armor, because I am crazy, but I think I want to try out the normal armor first, before I actually get going onto the crazy armor. So, let's see. I will need a bunch of Tomium, first of all. Gold and some leather. So, I should be able to do most of that, actually. Let's just see what I got. Meaning, as in, Tomium. Okay, I definitely need some more Tomium. And let's carry a few pieces of gold on me. Tomium is made from... Oh, wow. Really that low on sand? No sand in here? No. Let me quickly mine some sand. Wow. I really expected me to have just a little bit more sand. Well, yeah. I'll be right back. Never mind. I realized that I got myself way too much great root logs anyway, and I can very easily farm those. So, I'm just gonna use, Greatwood logs for the source of magic, instead of using the special kinds of chiseled sandstone. So let's see. And whenever I stand here, I'm also recharging, which is so awesome. Just love that feature. Love it. So let's see. Let's quickly turn this off. Ring of Magnification. Let's wait for this thing to bubble. And I'm probably gonna do it in 4 different... Wait. How much can I make with this? I need 4, so... Oh, I can only make 16. Derp. Let's hope this is enough. Can I... Yeah, I need to do it like this then, I guess. I'm not sure if this thing will cause an overflow or something, but... I got... 7? I believe I got 7. Oh well. Yeah, I definitely got 7. Let's quickly push this. And that's why I absolutely love these pistons, because it just makes doing simple stuff like that even a lot easier, which is awesome. So let's quickly wait for this to bubble. There we go. Then I can do the rest. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's quickly don't mess all of this up, because I won't be getting anything extra from this anyway. There we go. So, let's see. Can I, first of all, make the normal Tamium armor? Let's see. Tamium helm. Tamium chestplate. Tamium leggings. And I won't be making Tamium boots, because I just love my boots of the Traveler way too much. And I don't think there are any future upgrades for them anyway, so I'm not gonna waste my stuff on that. So let's see, how does one make this into fortress armor? And oh darn, I need an emerald for the helmet, so I guess then I will just start off with the other pieces. So let's just put in a chest plate. To go with a chest plate, I want to do 4 ingots. And yep, I will definitely need to make a little bit more soon. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's quickly put this all away. Quickly, stuff that I don't need. Gold and leather. So leather can go there. Gold I will pop in there. And I think I am all good. So let's quickly double check the aspects. Metallum, Precantio, Tutamen. I'm currently burning down letters for the Tutamen, so that should be good. Okay, got that. And I got more than enough. Precantio. I just love that name, Precantio. Even pronouncing stuff like that. I don't even know what I'm saying right now. Oh well, let's just do this. Because I'm crazy. How much is the instability, actually? Oh, it's only a minor. Huh. Well, that's not bad. I was expecting it to be worse. Oh well. That's pretty nice then, I guess. So, let's see. Can I do this? Please be not so slow. Because I want to make awesome fortress armor. Because it's powerful. And I want to be carrying it around on me on a daily basis. Even though that won't allow me to fly, thinking about it. But I'm not sure if that will be a huge issue. Because I want to make this armor anyway. Because it's just so cool, don't you think? I definitely like it. So, final pieces of that. Currently infusing the rest of the stuff. It's surprising that this thing is a minor instability. And I already had more instability accruing to me than in the other one that has high instability. Which is actually quite weird if you think about it like that. But yeah, sure, why not. So, there we go. There we go. Wow, that was some nasty instability at the last. Ooh, Tamium Fortress. I don't even know how to pronounce that. Curia case? I'm not even sure. But, this looks awesome. How much just armor does this give? I got 3.5 right now. This thing gives me... Oh yeah, that's a lot better protected. Let me make just a little bit more Tamium ingots and I'll be right back. Alright guys, now it's time for the last bit of infusion for today's episode. So let's see, Tamium Fortress Tides. So that's a little bit cheaper, apparently. Which is always nice, I guess. Cheaper, always good. Which might just be just a very Dutch attitude, because that's what they mostly say about Dutch people. But that's not an issue. Yep, I should have all of this ready. So, let's go. Shouldn't be too difficult to achieve, since I got most of this stuff here ready. And my wand is currently also charging just while standing here. Is this thing also charging? Nope. Oh well. Can't have everything, I guess. Armor, float in. There we go. Sometimes it just takes a little bit to update, but once it actually gets going, it's pretty awesome. So, I'm really, really enjoying this Let's Play, and I really hope you guys enjoy it too. Because most of the time I am really focused on just straight up grinding stuff. Like, not just like as a pulverizer, but like actual doing stuff repeatedly and getting high powered machines and straight up going for the top stuff. And this episode, or this Let's Play, I'm doing that a little bit less than normally. Because, well, yeah, I'm just doing this Let's Play a lot calmer than normally. Which is actually a shock to most people that play on the server, because I'm already being very advanced compared to other people. So, nice! Now I got myself... This looks so awesome. I really feel like a very powerful thaumaturge just by wearing this. Oh, this is so amazing. So, I guess it would be a good wrapping up, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. Probably either next episode or between the episodes, I will just quickly infuse the Stomium helm. And I'm also planning on adding the Helm of Revealing upgrade to this. So I can just see aura nodes while having this thing on, which is absolutely epic, pretty much, I think. And oh wow, very high instability. Oh wow, this grants lifesteal. Yeah, that's very powerful. And oh wow, these things are all very dangerous. Well, I guess I will be going for the little bit less dangerous ones for now, just to get started. So, if you have any suggestions, feel free to let me know down in the comments section below. I always read all my comments, and I always like all of you guys' feedback, because together we make this awesome. And, oh, I'm getting tainted, so I'm really, yes, it's a good wrapping up point. So, take care, guys.